Hello everyone, in this video we're gonna see how to quickly create this vintage halftone that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then I will go to File, New, and let's actually create 4500 for the width and 3000 for the height. And in the resolution for this, I'm gonna change it to 300 because we want it to be in a very good quality, and I'll press OK. Alright, now because we want this to be as a template, we need to create a new layer and then call this layer image. After that, we're going to actually convert this blank layer to smart objects. So I will right click and choose convert to smart objects. And then I will right click again and choose edit content. Now I will go and you can open the image that you want to use, just like this in the smart object. And I will make it fit with the canvas, something like that. All right, let me make it a little bit more close up. Alright, something like this, I think it will look really cool. Alright, now you can either press Ctrl or Command S to save, or you can just close the tab and make sure to press Yes to save it. And there we go, we have our image in here, and this will be the base of our template. Alright, so the first thing I want to do is to add some adjustments. So I will go to Image, Adjustment, I will choose Shadow and Highlight. I think I would keep everything in here the same, maybe put it 30% amount of the shadow and press OK. Alright, now we'll go to Filter and choose Sharpen, and I will choose Unsharp Mask. For this image or the resolution of this file, I will put the amount 50% and the radius 50% or 50 pixels, and for the threshold I will keep it 0 and I will press OK. Alright, next I want to reduce the color of the image, so I will go to Image, Adjustment, and choose Hue Saturation. And let's actually make it minus 70 or 75. I want to have just a little bit of color to give it that vintage look, so I will keep it minus 70, and I will press OK. Alright, next I will go to my file again, and I will open this texture that we're gonna use for this, and I will make it fit just like that. And for this one, I will change the blending mode of this to, let's see, overlay, soft light. Let's keep it soft light for now. Now it's time for us to start adding our halftone of this. So to do that, we're gonna actually add it as a pattern. I mean, you can add the one that you have in the filters, but I think the one with the pattern, it worked best for me at least. So we'll go and choose pattern. And I will make sure to upload all this pattern that I created earlier. You will find them down in the description below. Alright, so I will open the pattern, and then I'm gonna set the scale to 50%, and I will press OK. Alright, now I will right click and convert this to smart object, and after that I will change the blending mode of it to hard mix. Now I think the best blending mode that works very good with the halftone is the hard mix in here. And the way to control hard mix is by actually playing with the fill, not the opacity. As you can see, if I put down the fill a little bit, you can see how it will blend better with the skin of the image. So we'll put it around 70%. And after that, I will go to filter and I will choose blur, and I will apply a Gaussian blur. And I will give it like 1 pixel radius blur, and I will press OK. Alright, next I want to play with the angle of this halftone, and to do that you can easily do it by going to filter, distort, and then I will go to twirl. Now this is not like something that you want to have like very exaggerated. You can just play with the angle a little bit, but don't go too much because it won't look that good. Basically it will distort the pattern. So for me, I like to keep it down between 50 to 1. For this one, I will put 30 and I will press OK. And as you can see, it will give it a really nice twirl to the whole thing. Now, if you want more like filters, you can do that. But for this one, I think it looks really cool like this. Now, the other thing that I want to add is another blur. So we'll go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and I will keep it 1 and I will press OK. Now we are ready with our pattern. As you can see, it looks really cool. Now the other thing that I want to add is another texture. So I will go and open the texture that I want to use. It's this one. And then I'm going to change the blending mode of this to either screen or lighten. So I will keep it screen. And this will just give it this really nice vintage edges of the for the image. Now if you want other dimensions or other resolution of this, you will find it down in the Patreon, and also for the YouTube members it will be available. Alright, so the last thing that we can do is to apply a gradient map. So I will go and choose a gradient map, and for the gradient, it's basically you can play with the black points or the black stop of the colors and the light one. So for example, you can change this first color to something darker, and as you can see, it will affect the shadow of the image. So let's actually choose something vintagey like this. All right, and then I will go to the white stop or the white colors or the lights, and let's choose something bluish, maybe even like this to have it more vintage. And let's stick with the yellowish area. Yeah, something like this. I think it looks really interesting. And maybe emphasize the color of the blacks a little bit. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks really interesting. Maybe play with the location too. All right, so I think it looks really cool. Now we'll drop down the opacity quite a bit, because I only wanted to have a little bit of this on the image. Alright, I think it looks really cool. Now you can keep this or remove it. For me, I think it gives it a really nice vintage look to the whole thing. And of course, you can add as many adjustment layers as you want. But for me, I think I will keep it like this. And the good thing about this, we created it as a photo template, which means that you can just open the smart object and add another image, and it will apply the same effect on it. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial, and this was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know where for more to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.